Hi there, I'm an indie game developer working on a cozy medieval village building game using my own game engine, and this devlog is all about UI. Now, the game is still in a fairly early stage. I have a lot of the internal systems laid out, but there's still a lot to work on, and to be honest, at this point there's almost no content in the game. Surely there is a lot of more important stuff to work on rather than UI, right? Well, let me tell you something. From the very beginning of this project, I knew that working on UI will be a deep rabbit hole, and I knew that I need to postpone working on it as long as possible. The problem is that I really couldn't delay it any longer. My game can be described as a mix of different genres, such as a colony builder, a city builder, or an economic strategy, but most importantly, it is a simulation game. What it means is that it has a stupidly large amount of moving parts, objects changing with time, and interactions that happen almost every frame. And it is crucial that the player has all the means to analyze and influence all these changes and interactions. And the only reasonable way to do that is UI. In fact, I'm already struggling to test and debug the game without some UI, even if it has a jokingly low amount of content. Previously, I would simply map each new action to some button on the keyboard, but right now half of the keyboard is already mapped and I hardly remember what button does what. What is worse, some actions can have settings and I need to test all the various combinations of those settings. For example, a tree stump can be used to split tree logs into firewood or to craft woven baskets. These in turn can be set up to only use a specific kind of wood like birch or spruce. These tasks can also have some repeating conditions, like only splitting the logs if you're running out of firewood. Of course, I could just hard code what particular setting I'm testing right now, but that means I can't use two different settings in the same game run. I could also try to devise some intricate keyboard-based way of interacting with the game, but this would probably take about as much time as just making a proper UI. I've actually started prototyping the look of the UI a bit earlier, and I think I've come up with some really nice designs. As usual, I'm using my vector graphics library to draw all this. However, tool icons are something that's really hard to draw from code. I also can't just use hand-drawn sprites for them, because I need them in different styles with specific colors and lighting. What I really need is some vector graphics editor to draw these icons as polygons, and then export those polygons in my library. I considered several options, including importing from the SVG format, but all the options were less efficient than just creating this editor myself. So, after about one evening, I had this nice simple editor that I can use to create icons in a stupidly simple format, and that's really all I need. But to actually implement all this UI in code, I need to design some sort of UI framework. If I had just a few buttons, I could simply hardcode their style and positions and call it a day. However, as we've already discussed, this game needs a ton of UI, and manually positioning every single element is simply not an option. Believe me, unfortunately, I know what I'm talking about. I actually had a pretty functional UI framework in my engine already, but honestly, I just hate it. It is designed as a traditional class hierarchy type of thing, with a base UI element class and all other element types being subclasses. It works, but once you need something non-trivial with continuously updating tables with buttons that need to preserve their state, it all becomes an unusable mess. By the way, I've written a long blog post about this framework, which I'll link in the video description. So, if I don't like my previous UI framework, I probably need a new one. The first idea that came to my mind is using the entity component system for that. After all, my whole game relies on the ECS right now, so why don't I use it for the UI as well? And at first it looked like an excellent idea. If I want something to be clickable, I add a button component to it. If I want to highlight a certain UI element, I add a highlight component, and so on. However, I quickly found a lot of flaws in this approach. First, UI is always hierarchical, and traversing object hierarchies in a traditional ECS is, well, possible, but quite unnatural. Secondly, there were a lot of cases when I needed a specific entity to handle a specific event, without knowing what this entity actually is. Essentially, I needed something like virtual functions in an ECS, which is possible to implement, but at this point I'm just recreating object-oriented programming inside an ECS, which honestly sounds horribly wrong. After that, I turned to another UI framework prototype that I've been designing at some point last year. It is heavily inspired by the React web framework and takes a lot of ideas from it, like declarative UI description, reactive state and reconciliation. Don't worry if you have no idea what anything of this means, it doesn't really matter now. Yet again, at first this approach seemed really nice, but it really struggled with more complicated UI and quickly turned into an unmaintainable mess. Lastly, I decided to try something called Immediate Mode UI. You might know it from the excellent Dear MGUI library, which is a popular choice for making some debug UI. The downside of Immediate Mode UI is that you essentially recreate the whole UI on every frame, which actually isn't such a bad idea, given that in games it is quite common for many things to change each frame. And while you describe the UI, you immediately insert code that handles various events like mouse clicks, which seems weird at first, but it actually leads to quite simple and readable code. I managed to distill the number of base UI elements to just 4 of them: an image, a text label, and 2 containers implementing automatic layout, like arranging the buttons in this panel. All the other UI components are built on top of these 4, which kinda shows how flexible this approach is. Now that I'm happy with the UI framework, I need to use it to make the actual game UI. First, I made this bottom tools panel. Half of these buttons don't work, like you can't mine or dig anything yet. But you can select some trees to be chopped, grass to be harvested, or mushrooms and berries to be foraged. You can also click this build tool, which opens a new menu with all the stuff that you can build in the game. In the future, this menu will almost certainly become more complicated and split into categories, but for now a simple list will do. Next, I added probably the most important part of the whole UI, which is the ability to select any object in the game and a panel on the left telling me everything I need to know about this object. For example, if I select this grass patch, it tells me what it is and also that it can be harvested, what tool does it require to be harvested and so on. Or if I select this tree stump, I can first claim it for my settlement and then I can add new tasks for it, like splitting logs into firewood. And of course, I can change the settings of a particular task. Lastly, I added a simple panel showing the current date and time on the top of the screen. Again, there isn't much UI right now, but I'll be adding it as I need it in the future. There is a lot more that I could say about making the UI for my game, but that probably wouldn't fit into a devlog. Though I am planning to write a comprehensive blog post about all the UI approaches that I've tried. Now that I have the UI, I can start making some swift progress with the actual gameplay and content. But before that, I have just one more thing to do, which however will require a separate devlog. Stay tuned if you wanna learn what it is, and I hope to see you next time.